Hello, GOAT Format Duelist. I want to show you one of the most egregious cases of cheating that I can recall, at least from recent memory. So I'm going to show you the cheating first, then probably after that I'll go on a mini rant about cheating in general and what I think should be done about this. But let's go ahead and get into it. I'm ACP, welcome to GOAT Duels, and this was a match played between Estardo Escoto versus Yugioh. I apologize for butchering those names. I think one is like Spanish and the other might be Italian or something. So the cheating was Yugioh. He was the one who cheated here, and we'll get into exactly what happened. This replay was sent in to me by the other player, so you know, I've had permission from one player to post this replay. And in general, I think we need to, like, the GOAT Format community needs to take a harder stance on cheaters. I was reading this article the other day about the developers at a game called Escape from Tarkov. It's like a first-person shooter survival-type game. And basically what they've been doing is every time they, like, ban a wave of cheaters, they publicly shame them. They go, these are the people who cheated, this is what they did, etc. So that's, I don't know, doing my mini version of this, I guess. Let's go ahead. So the cheating happens in game two. This is game one. So I'm gonna just go through game one pretty quickly. Just gonna fast forward here. I think it's just, you know, standard chaos mirror. Nothing to see here, guys. Yugioh does win game one, I believe. So yeah, BLS is a good card as it turns out. Okay. So now we're gonna get into game two, and the cheating happens pretty early on, I believe. It happens within like the first couple of turns. So yeah, we got a good opening here, and we're also gonna bring up the log at some point. Okay, so yeah, Estardo draws into delinquent duo. Obviously, he plays the delinquent duo. So here's what happens: he plays duo. Opponent shuffles, so he goes, okay, I'm free to pick. Picks Graceful Charity, which, clearly the best card in this guy's hands, right? Clearly the best card. However, Yugioh shuffles. Estardo picks again, hits Magician of Faith, and then he discards the Magician of Faith. Okay, and then the shenanigans begin. So we're gonna read the chat here. So, yeah, he picks Faith, and then Estardo asks, was that the original card that I picked? And he says, yes. He's like, yep, you picked the Faith both times. Yeah, so you can read the chat here. He's like, yep, it was always the same card. Estardo calls a judge and says, you know, he says, hey, can you just show me the log? But he goes, imager doesn't work. And then he says, can you copy and paste the log? So we'll see what the actual log is, right? You can see the log in the replay. So we can see what happened is, Delinquent Duo was activated, pointed at Graceful Charity, hand was shuffled, pointed at Magician of Faith. But then here's what happens. Yugioh, what he does is he copy and pastes the log, but changes it. So he basically alters the log when he copies and pastes it. He takes the Graceful Charity in the log, swaps it out with Magician of Faith, copy and pastes that in the chat. So at this point, he's just maliciously cheating. Now the judge comes. You can see the green name, Kitty Trouble. That's the judge. The judge comes. Yugioh immediately quits because he realizes that he's going to be caught. So Yugioh quits. And then, yeah, Estardo's like, he knows what's going on. He's like, why would this guy quit unless he just realizes that he was caught cheating? So he asks the judge, hey, can you check? Judge is like, yep, the person was in fact cheating. And, Kitty Trouble freezes Yugioh. Yeah, and apparently Yugioh was frozen for a week. That's what I've been told. So here's what happened. Now here's where the rant starts. My issue with this is that to me, when we're talking about like punishments for things you shouldn't be doing within the scope of a game, to me there's kind of two things you should look at. One, what happened, and two, what the intent was. Now, for me, as far as like what happened, there are two kinds of things that can get you in trouble. One is when you do something that is unsportsmanlike but not gameplay related. For example, if I was in a game with my opponent at a YCS and I called my opponent the R word, that would obviously be very unsportsmanlike and should deserve a punishment, but is not gameplay related. Then there are things like, oh, I, stacked my deck, or I, did the classic thing of I removed a card from my opponent's deck, called the judge, and got them a game loss. Something like that. Something where I'm manipulating the actual gameplay pieces. In my opinion, things that are gameplay related should have a harsher punishment than things that are non-gameplay related. In the sense that, like, if someone's cheating, that should be the worst thing that you can do in a game because that affects who actually wins and loses, right? If I, call my opponent a mean word in a game, yes, that's bad, but it doesn't affect who actually wins the game. It doesn't compromise the integrity of the tournament in the sense that the person who deserves to win is still going to win. And like a good example of that, in my opinion, is one of my friends at a YCS. He was banned for 5 years for smoking the devil's lettuce at the venue. Not even like where the tournament was being held, but just at the venue in general. So like the tournament was being held like at a hotel, and he was, I guess he posted a picture on social media of him smoking a recreational substance at that particular hotel. Not even where the tournament was. Konami saw that picture, banned him for 5 years. Then, meanwhile, you have people like, I don't know, say Adam Korn, Roy St. Clair, whatever, just get caught cheating, like, pretty much every time they're allowed to play. And they just get banned for, say, 1 year, and then are allowed to just come back and cheat again. I don't think that's right. The second thing is that, I think intent matters in the sense that, like, can you prove that they were maliciously trying to gain an unfair advantage? Here, the answer is clearly yes. With other things, for example, like, oh, your opponent was under reckless greed, you let them draw a card and get them a game loss. Now, that is cheating, but it's very difficult to prove. It's very difficult to prove if someone did that maliciously or if they just weren't able to stop them in time, didn't know, whatever. So, to me, things like this that we can prove that affect gameplay should just be a lifetime ban. Like, they really should, because the person has shown their character, it's clear what they're trying to do. If they're trying to cheat in like some unranked game that doesn't matter, well, imagine what they would do in a tournament where money was on the line. So that's kind of my rant, and I think this player deserves to be banned for life. I also want to call out briefly Giorgione's friends. A lot of these people are top players that are, very noteworthy in the GOAT format community, right? People like Don't Copy, people like MMF, Matt Uber, Pooey, whoever. These are people who clearly know this person and are active in the, GOAT format scene. If not running tournaments themselves, they're certainly entering them. Lots of people here that are noteworthy. So honestly, like, I hope people who are running online GOAT format tournaments just ban this person, right? Even if we go back, yeah, we can see here that, this person plays a ton of GOAT format. They even have like a pretty good win rate. They're rating roughly about like two-thirds of their games. They were active recently. As I'm recording this, they were active 3 hours ago. Clearly have been playing GOAT format for a long time, right? They've been here since 2017, played GOAT format way more than current. Ideally, I would like to see this person banned from tournaments. And I don't know like why Dueling Book just bans these people for like a week. That's basically not even a punishment. Like, I hate to say it. Like, if someone told me I couldn't play a game that I liked for a week, I'd just be like, okay, I'll do something else for that next week, and then just immediately come back. To me, that's just not even a punishment. Like, it's really not. In my mind, this should be an IP ban. I mean, ban the account at a minimum. Problem is, if you just ban the account, well, they'll just make a new account. It's not really any different. So, yeah, I mean, certainly, you know, like on Goat Duels and we have a simulator. Yeah, the approach that I'm going to take is, if you're cheating and it was obvious that you were cheating, you're just gone. Like, there shouldn't be any, like, negotiations. I see so many people trying to, like, apologize for cheaters or just act like they should be, like, unbanned, like, a couple weeks later. I mean, this would happen all the time. You know, either people that I caught cheating or people that other people caught cheating where it's like, oh, yeah, you banned this cheater, but it's been, like, 2 months. Can they come back now? It's like, no. No, they can't. Like, what message are you sending? The message that you're sending is cheating isn't a big deal. You can come back, do it again. And from my experience, like, I hate to say it, too, like, I can't think of really any, like, reformed cheaters. People who just used to cheat a lot. Then they got banned, then they came back and stopped cheating. Can't think of any examples. Maybe someone will think of an example. I can't think any. Most of these cheaters, again, they get banned. You know, Konami usually bans them for, like, a year. They come back a year later, almost immediately, too. Like, the first day they're able to play again, they're back, and they're just cheating again. That's what happened with, again, most of the well-known cheaters, like Adam Korn, Roy St. Clair, whatever. They just cheated the whole time, never stopped, never got a lifetime ban. These people would get one-year bans. Meanwhile, oh, you know, you smoked some substance at an event, you get a 5-year ban. Why is it that we're punishing those people 5 times as much as actual cheaters? I don't know. That's obviously, I'm editorializing a bit. I understand, like, yeah, this is all subjective. That's the same in other games, too. Like, even in Magic the Gathering, like, there's definitely been some cheaters who get banned for a year, come back, go back to cheating. A lot of these people, though, they get better at cheating. That's the thing, too, you have to realize. Like, if you get caught cheating and you get banned and you're allowed to come back, the message that you're sending almost all of the time is you need to get better at cheating. You need to get better at not being caught. That is the message that these people are receiving. But if you just don't allow them to play anymore, then I think that deals with the problem better. You know, you have to realize, too, like, with GOAT format, we're not talking about kids. Like, if it's someone who gets caught cheating at, like, age 13, and the view is, well, they can change, let's let them back after a year, okay, I get that, because, yes, you can change. But people who play GOAT format, you know, I realize we're all boomers, right? Yeah, like, the people who play GOAT format, they're like 20, 30 years old. They're not 12. You know, they're grown-ass adults. They know what they're doing. And, yeah, I mean, especially as GOAT format grows and as we do see a few tournaments every year where thousands of dollars on the line, I think at some point, if not now, this is going to become an issue that needs to be addressed directly. And I think it's very important. There's obviously a lot of things that are important, but to me, ensuring the integrity of the game is one of the most important things. And I actually think, too, if GOAT format takes a harder stance on cheating than normal Yu-Gi-Oh! Does, than Konami does, I think that can actually be kind of a selling point. In the sense that there's a lot of things that people don't like about current format, things people don't like about the way that Konami runs Yu-Gi-Oh! I've always thought that cheating is one of them. You know, there are times where people are just caught on camera cheating. Or, you know, caught, particularly during the remote duel era, you saw tons of people getting caught cheating. And not really a whole lot happened to them. And that's a problem. But the GOAT format, we're kind of, you know, we're keeping our distance from Konami. We're our own community. We can do whatever punishments we want, right? If you're running a GOAT format tournament, at the end of the day, the TO gets to decide who gets to play and who doesn't. And if you're running some sort of online dueling platform like Dueling Book, you get to decide who gets to play and who doesn't. Now, your ability to enforce that, of course, that can be tricky. That can be easier said than done. On the internet, you got people multi-accounting, you know, spoofing their IPs, whatever. I get that. It's a lot harder than, like, in real life to control who can enter, who can't. But I think we should try our best. So yeah, that's the end of my rant. Let me know what you guys think. Keep sending me your dueling replays, guys. I always get a kick out of it. And yeah, take care.